EFTD. Okay.
I'd first just like to welcome the Greek Minister to coming to talk to us today. I've got very many questions I'd like to ask you, Mr. Minister, but I really don't see the point, because whatever you say doesn't matter now. You are being used as a mouthpiece and a puppet for the German government, big European banks and the EU institutions. I'd be better off addressing any questions about Greece I have to the unelected Commission representatives sat over there than an elected member of Greece. Do you really think that the people in this room care about the people of Greece? Do you think the Commission cares about the employment figures, the suicide rates and the social destruction? No. All they want is more money from your people to pay off their banks and prop up this failing Eurozone. What did the people of Greece do about all this? They voted three times against austerity, two general elections and a referendum. Each time they said no to EU-imposed austerity, and yet they've locked Greece into the most severe austerity, privatisation and sell-offs ever seen. What's the point of voting in Greece if you can't change anything? Greece has been sold out. The democracy has been sold out. And then you come here to ask the EU to support you. Well, that beast is not for turning. If you really want to help your country, if you really want to save Greece, there is only one option. President Hollande said it last week in Strasbourg. You either accept more EU control or you leave. Lead Greece to her freedom, to be able to protect public services, jobs and the welfare of her people. There is a brave new world out there if you would only throw down the shackles the EU's put down upon you. Germany and the EU institutions rule Greece now, and the sooner you understand this, the better things may become. Thank you, sir.
Minister, du hast das Wort.
Minister, you have the floor.
In Fragen möglichst.
Hopefully you can try to answer all of these questions.
I'll try to answer all the questions, the specific ones in brief, and I'll try to answer the clusters of questions related to democracy and the perspectives of making social-friendly policy within the memoranda in common. Regarding the question about how we are going to encourage new businesses, we have that in mind. We are not against entrepreneurial effort. Problem we have is the Greek banks are still moribund. And if we do not have the recapitalization soon, this is not be easy to help startups. This is the reason we are putting a special concern on the success of the first review we have now of the program, because after that we are going to have the recapitalization of the banks. I have now a very interesting cluster of questions saying basically that we do not have a social deficit, but it is obvious by the negotiations and the way that they have ended that we have also a problem of democracy. This is true. But as I said before, my government and the left, the European left in Greece, who is represented by Syriza, wants to stay in Europe exactly because we want to change it, because we want to have, we want to strengthen its social dimension. We want to strengthen also the democratic potential of institutions like the European Parliament. That's one of the reasons that we have addressed to you and ask you to find a way to oversee the new negotiation process. It's clearly not a bilateral issue between us and the lenders, who are also our partners. It is clearly a European issue. And if you think more profoundly on that, we have again, throughout these 6 months of hard negotiations between Greece and the institutions, Europe and IMF, we have created a common European public space. Every time that Mr. Schäuble or Mr. Varoufakis were making a speech, this has been translated simultaneously throughout all our countries. So, contrary to what's happening in the past, we do not have just parallel national monologues on the same issue, austerity, or, let's say, deregulation. We had a structured dialogue on the national, on the transnational European level, which are prerequisite for having European democracy. If we do not have a common public space, we cannot have working and functional democracy. So these things are going in parallel, strengthening the social dimension and strengthening also the democratic aspects of the European institutions.